Hello, it's Kat, and this week I'm back in Adobe Firefly. I want to go over a feature really quickly that I overlooked in my first video, use as reference image. What this does is allow you to take your generated image and continue iterating on it. It even has this handy slider where you can define how closely you want the image to resemble your original image versus any tweaks you may have made to the prompt. So let's jump in with an example. So I've gone through the gallery to pick out a prompt I want to start with, and I'm going to choose this cute character design. Out of these four images, I really like this one. It's the closest to the original one that I chose. So if you go under this options menu and choose use as reference image, you'll see that it brings up this new dialogue with a slider bar down here, and we can define how close we want this next generation to be to the original reference image versus the prompt. I'm going to keep it fairly close, and let's say we want to change a word in the prompt. You can see that these are all just slightly different generations of the same image. It's very close to the original. What if we wanted portrait of a cute brunette girl instead? I'm going to reclick generate. Now that didn't change very much, if at all. So I'll pop this back open by clicking on the reference image, and I'm going to move it more towards the center. And if you click that again, it will close and we'll wait for this to regenerate. Now we can see that it's given us options that are closer to the prompt, but it's retaining the style and composition of the original image. So that's your Firefly tip for this week. I'm going to keep iterating on this prompt and others and start gathering some reference for a mood board so that I can show you guys how you might use this as character reference for your own vector illustrations. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments. I'm always happy to help. As always, have a great day and happy illustrating.